So, it's time to end this, but beforehand, I need to set up a few things. Mainly in the elements. This isn't a case where I can just decide to move things however I want. Chrono Cross needs to be with a Surge. And I need to think. Long story short, what I'm doing is, if you remember all the notes we kept hearing, the order of the colors and everything we kept seeing, that comes into play here. If you kind of screw this up, you can actually... Oh, do I need to go to homeworld for this? I'm in the wrong spot. Do I need to go to homeworld for this? Basically, if you screw this up, you can... still, back out of the fight and try again. And I would recommend it. Yep. So now, we are joined by the three kids. So, what's interesting there is they pretty much say that Shala and Lavos unified become the Devourer of Time. There's actually, if you've ever played Chrono Trigger on the Nintendo DS, it has additional content after you fight Lavos that kind of expands a little bit and tries to connect the game more to Chrono Cross, which the new final boss there is the Dream Devourer. And now we know who Kid really is. Kid is Shala's daughter clone. Talk to Marley first. I'm talk to Chrono here. Also, I gotta love it in this game, Chrono talks. Also, we got a lot skinnier. Oh, goody. So Lynx was actually our father. So, yeah, we just got a butt ton of plot thrown at us. But, it is time. So here, we use the time egg to the darkness of time. So the game is pretty much hinting that yes, there are two ways to end this. You're going to be doing the simpler way, if it can be pulled off. So there is the Devourer of Time along with Shala. So, here's what we're going to do. Basically tap him a few times. He's going to attack with Bushbash. At this point, note that green is up there. Ignore that. Okay, so first up. Yellow. Red. Green. Black. I may have somehow screwed this up a bit. I may have goofed. Nope. So, here's the thing. From what I've heard from watching speedruns, and I will probably test this out at some point. At this point, the Devourer of Time's AI should be locked, meaning, to my knowledge, it can't do anything to you at this point. However, we have one more thing we need to do. So once you use the elements in the correct order, and if you're good enough, you can actually have the Time Devourer use Bushwhacker on you and count that as the green. But once between you and the Time Devourer, you've used elements in the order of yellow, red, green, blue, black, and white. Activate the Chrono Cross. I'm going to sit back and let the game take over, because this is one of the best endings I've ever seen to a game.
And with that, we have final credits.
Yeah, so first off, yeah, I wanted to stay silent through that because one of the best things about this game is its soundtrack. I am a huge fan of, like, the NES, Super NES soundtracks and such, but I'm just gonna say, the Chrono Cross soundtrack is probably one of the most beautiful pieces of video game music I've ever heard. Especially everything from when you use the Chrono Cross, even through the credits. So yeah, so there's a couple things of note, is that was the good ending. So when you first fight the Time Devourer, you can actually get one of two endings. The good ending, obviously, you use the six elements in order, and then use the Chrono Cross, and you free Shala. If you decide instead to just try to defeat the Time Devourer outright, you can. But it will eventually just go up into the sky, it'll disappear along with Shala, and then it goes straight to credits. Everything else that happens, like the whole returning to your world and saying goodbye and all that, does not happen. I don't know in terms of like the game's lore or story or anything what actually happens like in that case, but yeah, it's considered the bad ending. Now, like Chrono Trigger, there is a New Game Plus in a way. I can think there's a couple different versions of it that allow you to like bring over the characters you've already gotten. And that's how you can pretty much get up to like a total of 99 stars by doing that. Going through the game again with the characters you've already gotten and all your stats and everything. And much like Chrono Trigger, there are multiple endings. And it all depends on when you decide to go back to Opassa Beach to beat the Time Devourer again. So, as the credits play, overall thoughts on the game. I enjoyed this. Like I said, the first time I played it, I was in college. I'd borrowed it from a friend. Never had a chance to go all the way through it. But, I got up to where Link's first take Surge's body. Didn't get too much further. Now that I had a chance to go back, to completely go through the game, I really enjoyed it. In my opinion, I would kind of consider this an underrated game, because when you hear people talk about like different games, like some of the really good games on different platforms and stuff, I mean, people may mention Chrono Cross, but I remember when I was like at least in college, not a lot of people really discussed Chrono Cross. Now between Chrono Cross and Chrono Trigger, which I enjoyed more, I still kind of enjoy Chrono Trigger more. But it's not to say I did not enjoy Cross. I really enjoyed my time playing through this again. As for the project itself, am I going to go any further with it? Probably not. I might do like a little amendment video or something like that, just showing off trying to beat the Time Devourer straight up. Which, again, from what I've heard from speedruns, once you use the first six elements, you've locked the Time Devourer. I don't know if you can... To my knowledge, that means that he will not attack you. I could be completely wrong on what they meant by that. Also, I don't know if that is the case, if he won't attack you. If you use another element to break the string, will that unlock his AI? I don't know. That would be something that I would probably just test out on my own. Post like a little update saying here's what it is and all that. But in terms of the actual project itself, this is pretty much the end of the project. And there are a lot of credits. Again, that's fine though, because the music in this game is amazing. So all of those shots of the girl with the ponytail, with the bow in her hair, just randomly walking around. That supposedly is Kid trying to find you in the real world. Also, she is really obsessed with trying to find you. So, the whole thing with the gameplay recorded being blocked, to my knowledge, I'm watching on Streamlabs, everything seems to have come through. I'll have to see what the video looks like. But, yeah, we also got the trophy for a new future. I'm guessing that's because we got the good ending. I don't know if there's one for the bad ending. But at this point, you can sit here and listen to the music. So definitely go ahead and save the game. Continue, what would happen? So, New Game Plus and Continue Plus. So, to kind of look those up real quick, what those actually are. Alright, so Continue Plus is, so this is according to the walkthrough in IGN. Continue Plus is a feature that imports certain aspects from a New Game Plus clear data into a non-New Game Plus save file. This includes recruited characters, stats, and growth stars, among others. It becomes available soon after loading your clear data, and is used primarily to recruit characters without starting more than one New Game Plus playthrough. Let's see. To start, it must be said that Continue Plus can only load non-New Game Plus data. So to use the feature effectively, you need a save file from playthrough number one, where you already have the Chrono Cross. Save files for the game's branch points are a definite advantage, but only a near-end game save is actually required. And it goes through about how to go ahead and use the Continue Plus and all that, which I'm not going to do here. But with that, that is pretty much it for the project. And it's not going to let me back up, is it? Nope. Okay. Yeah, it's not going to let me back up at that point. What if I get a continue question here? I got a New Game Plus. Okay, New Game Plus just completely starts new game. Ha! Start with Fargo. Nice. Okay. Cool. So yes, even though we got panic music, I'm going to go and do this. And go close the application down. So yeah. So, that is all I've got for this playthrough of Chrono Cross. I hope you guys enjoyed that as much as I did. Again, overall quick final thoughts. If you're thinking about checking out the game, definitely do so. It takes a little getting used to with the element system, the grids, and all that. But once you start getting into it, and you're a lot better than I am when it comes to choosing your elements for your grids, it is a really fun game. So, with that is it for Chrono Cross. Hope you guys enjoyed the project. I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.